Hi, in this video we will look at how to access mWater's instructional video library, create an mWater account, set up an organization, and add several enumerators to new organizations. Additionally, we will show you how to find resources to help you navigate mWater's portal as a first-time user. First, the video library, which contains several tutorials about using mWater and Solstice, can be accessed by clicking on the Manuals and Tutorials green button on the mWater portal page. This then takes you to the mWater Resource Center, and if you click the video channel on the bottom of the page, it will take you to the mWater YouTube channel, where under the Videos tabs, these tutorials can be found. Make sure to subscribe on the right-hand side to stay up to date on our new videos. There are multiple ways to create an mWater account. The easiest way is to open the mWater portal online and click the green sign up button. From there, you can fill out the appropriate sections like given name, family name, username, password, and email address. You also have the option of including an employer or organization name that you can tie to your username, and those will be related. But this is not mandatory to create an account. Once you have finished that, check the box to confirm that you are at least 13 years of age, and then click the sign up button. This will then take you to a login page where you can type in your new username or corresponding email and password to log in to your new mWater account. Another way to create an mWater account is through the app. You can reach the web version of the app by typing in app.mwater.co online. This will then take you to the app login screen where you would click Create an Account. You can also download the app via the App Store on an iOS devices and go search for mWater Surveyor. Once you again fill in the appropriate sections, given name, family name, username, email address, and once you confirm that you are over 13 years of age, you will be able to successfully create an account and log into the app. Successful login will be shown on the top right corner of the screen where a green note will appear. Additionally, make sure to confirm your email address using the link that was mailed to the email address that you signed up with. If for some reason you do not see the email to confirm, on the app and the web version of the app, there is an option to resend the email at the top portion of the screen. Next, we will be taking a look at how to set up organizations in mWater. So what exactly are organizations? Essentially, they are hierarchies of branches in mWater or Solstice, where every branch has its own user groups and deployments. Organizations make management at scale much easier by creating tree-like hierarchy, where users are added to individual branches. This allows for data from more than one survey and multiple users to be managed in a central location. To set up an organization, on the portal, click Manage, then click on Organizations, then click on the blue button that says Create an Organization. Fill in the name and description of the new organization and click Save. For the sake of this example, we will call our organization Model NGO. For example, this is one big data collection enterprise here under this example non-governmental organization. You can then add different sections under Model NGO, such as offices that are in different countries. So as you can see here, this slices across three different countries so that you can see the hierarchy of the organization is split between three different locations. You can also add groupings under those countries relevant to the work that is being done in each office, for example, Program A and Program B. So, to ensure enumerators have access to an organization, the administrators must first manually add their usernames to the organization. If the administrators don't do this, then the enumerators won't have access to any surveys that are deployed by the organization. So, in order to do this, each enumerator must first make an mWater account and have their username known by the administrator of the organization. So to then add enumerators to the organization, organization managers must create a team of enumerators in the intended level of hierarchy of the organization and type their name and select them from the drop-down menu. So each branch of the organization has the following groups. It has admins, which they can add and remove branches, create and remove teams, and add users to teams. There are also managers, and managers are automatically added as managers into deployments made from this branch. There are viewers. They are automatically added as viewers in deployments made from this branch. And then there are teams, which is an additional group type often used for assigning enumerators, as what was shown before. So it is important to note that permissions are given at the organization's top branch flow downwards. So if someone is a viewer at the top branch, there are also viewers on every lower branch. Permissions on other branches don't flow down. So notice that once enumerators are added as a team to a specific branch of the organization, they already have access to all the deployments of that branch. So for more information about the role of organizations and its many functions, you can visit the mWater's video library and watch the tutorial titled Managing Users and Surveys at Scale with Organizations. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope this was helpful for new users just getting started with mWater.